Testing, 1, 2. Testing, 1, 2.
Cool. Back in the 76. My camp is going to load in slowly. Parts of it are loading in. Let's look this way. Load in. Took its time. God damn it. Yeah, I need to sell some stuff and try and buy as much through a ammunition as I can. And then I'm gonna be waiting. Waiting. And waiting. Until I can take the ammunition depot for myself. I'm gonna go take that and I'm gonna set it making 308. And I'm gonna defend it. Sort of. Yeah, this bit of music that you were just hearing, that is definitely copyrighted. Boy, do I know that phone.
You can gear up here. You know the drill. Buy and sell. Responders, set up this trading post for their fire breathers unit. Fire breather in the station. Oh, you're taking the fight to those scorched.
I believe that this camp is technically a raider camp. Well, trader. Even.
Previously owned loot for sale, mostly blood free. don't stab other customers while they shop. Caps available in exchange for pillaged loot. Pillaged loot available in exchange for caps. You looking at me? How about you stop looking and start buying? Vendor not responsible for your safety or the safety of goods purchased.
Head to Big Al's. Get another mission from Biv. Biv is a pretty laid back robot. He is a Bivbot.
Chambers all day long.
I need. That's going to be the hard one, Tarberry. But I think I can get... off. Fuck's sake. Fuck off! Right, I think I can get razor grain on the farm that's outside town. Thank you.
good.
Where can I get Tarberry? I have no idea. No idea. I've got wild blackberries up by my camp. I have seen tarberries, but I've only seen a few of them. can't do that because I don't have enough ammunition to do it. Do that. We'll have a look at that. Wavy Willard's Water Park. I've had this mission for a long time. I just haven't gotten around to it. Also, since I'm using non-standard weapons, at least as far as I'm concerned, any opportunities to get ammunition from places is greatly appreciated. I'll be taking it. Anyone who reads this, my group was attacked by super mutants while we were travelling past Lady Jane's soft serve. I managed to get away, but all my friends were torn apart. I'm ashamed of this. I was too afraid to help them. Then I am too afraid to take vengeance now. Please, if you could, avenge my friends. Well, I can't give you anything, just know I'd appreciate it. God damn it. Thank you.
Excusez-moi, user. You're here to find Freddy? His father. He put a tracker on Freddy that the lovely boy could not remove. But on that terrible day, it stopped. The policemen, they tried. It was simple. Clues were found here. Then came all of this. My Freddy, he was not found.
He could live, no? You live, so he could. Such a clever boy. Now, maybe a man. Such a long time to wait for word of mon petit chou. But Nanny, she cannot bypass privacy protocol. To enter the security office is unauthorized. Maybe you can enter?
Sure. Had a missing child, Freddy, who may have been kidnapped from our very own water park. As part of our anti-war protest movement, and our security staff are working closely with the Grafton police to find the child. Any employee that is able to come in and help review security holotapes will be paid overtime for the hours they spend. Night shift notes, 12 hours, kids grilling at the pool, got nothing, Bob. Day shift notes, looked at slither slide and kiddie slide for 12 hours, found a tape that is probably the kid getting nabbed at the slither. I think the kid knew the guy, put it in the sec office safe. The feds or whatever can take a look. Eight hours of nothing. Covered the fountain, Bob. Received 10 hours of bathroom footage. Dear God, some people. No sign of the kid. 6 hours of gator mouth. And another 4 of the picnic tables up top, no luck, Pete. 3 hours of confessions, got a guy acting real weird with a package. Might be the same guy as that slide tape. Setting it aside, I'll bring it to the office, end of shift, Tom. So over by the slither slide, or whatever.
Hello, sir. Welcome to Wavy Willard's Water Park. How can I help?
Howdy. Was wondering where that box is for the mail, the one that puts the special stamp on the ladder.
You can find it over by the Crocolossus Mountain entrance. Right over that way.
Right, so his ID is supposed to be over here by the slip and slide, I think. Secure keeps your kids safe. Serial number 132563. Made for Freddy Wood. Status error. That not the good. Letter to the media. Mail to Queen Carter, Charleston Herald, Miss. This key lets you open my box with all the evidence you need. Listen, I sent it to you because the truth has got to come out. You're Appalachia's most trusted news source, and people will listen if you do an investigation. Grafton Steel has been violating safety standards and getting people killed with the toxic sludge they're dumping into the water. They shouldn't get away with this just because they're doing military work for the war. Little kids are dying. Do not duplicate. PO Box 012. Postage guaranteed. I think there is a Tinker's Bench there. There is one in there, I think. That totally didn't help. Thank you. Age 7, height 3'11", weight 51 pounds. Description: last seen at Wavy Willards Water Park on October 17th, 2077. Attending a birthday party, he has brown hair, green eyes, and was last seen wearing a white t-shirt and brown shorts. If you or anyone you know have seen this boy or has information about his whereabouts, please contact Miss Annie, who is coordinating the search efforts in and around Wavy Willards Park. Notification. While every effort is made to ensure data is accurate, the Postal Service does not certify any information contained herein. The Postal Service is in no way responsible for any errors that occur in the records, nor liable for action taken as a result of reliance on this information. Box number 012, Otis Pike 316 W, Wilford Street, Grafton. Power armor's floating again. I've got a virus.
Responder. I am authorized to trade supplies. Ammunition and other supplies available for all responders.
Thank you.
Right, I didn't fix it. The kid secure thing. Whoops. Let's bounce. Let's leave this server then, since I clearly had all the materials, it was just having none of that for some reason. Fuck if I know. It's like, go repair it! What? No, you can't fix that. Why not? I have all the fucking requirements. Ah. It's dumb shit like this that annoys me. I mean, yesterday with the whole go to the DMV to get your military ID finalized so you can go into the Brotherhood's area. Like that, that's fun. It's kind of ridiculous, but it's fun. Termination. August 14th, 2077. Mr. Otis Pike, 316 W. Wilford Street, Grafton, sub. Employment termination. Mr. Pike, this letter serves as formal confirmation of our informal discussion today regarding the termination of your employment with Grafton Steel. It is unfortunate that you have been drawn into this ridiculous propaganda. As a law-abiding government contractor, Grafton Steel abides by our commitments to meet the exceeding standards of safety and production. You have demonstrated a complete disregard for Grafton Steel's reputation, its importance to the war effort, and repeated counsel intended to help you. Sincerely, Stacy Tibbetts, Human Resources Manager. So it sounds like he got fired. What's that note? Can I read that? Camp Tomahawk postcard. Hi Uncle Otis, it's me, Bobby. Puke four times. So cool. I saw a dead animal. There were lots of worms and stuff and guts. Susie, me, May, Susie May, bald. Girls are dumb. Freddy the Great. Calendar. Kid Secure. Okay, from Kid Secure customer support, August 23rd, 2077, to Otis Pike. Subject: read tracking feature. Dear Mr. Otis Pike, I'm sorry to hear about your issue you've been experiencing with your son's Kid Secure. Only an authorized adult that's been added to the account can remove the bracelet. We keep your kid secure. I've attached an override instruction as you requested. Please let us know if you have any further questions. Fuck. Damned safety inquiry. From Grafton Dam to Otis Pike. Re-safety inquiry. Mr. Pike, I'm happy to assure you that Grafton Dam is an amazing marvel of technological achievement. We have found that humans make too many mistakes, so other than a remote oversight capability, the Grafton Dam is fully automated. I would be happy to arrange a tour for you if you are interested furthermore. Sincerely, Quinton Geese, Community Outreach Manager. Ken. No, just no, we aren't related. You and I, Molly was the love of my life, and while she lived, I had to deal with your crap. What were you thinking trying to screw me over with the protests at the dam? You tried to take advantage of my money for your sister. What the hell? Freddy likes you. I can't prevent the kid secure from letting you locate him, since Molly trusted you as a guardian. So just go away, Otis. Fuck. Diary. It's probably dumb to write this down, but I gotta get my thoughts put down somewhere, so I guess this is where. Okay, let's start with February 26th, 2077. All systems are A-okay. Now Colton and Leyland have passed on. The steel mill just keeps pumping poison out. I'm not sure what to do. What can I do? I can't get other work with my back being so bad and Arthur is kin. May 7th, 2077. That cute Susie Jenkins died horribly with lumps growing inside her little body. I feel so bad for her. Folks, no one should have to bury a little child like that. I don't see that I have any choice. Arthur can't see past the dollar signs and doesn't give a crap about anything. People are dying. May 14th, 2077. I finally did it. I secretly told the news about what's happening here. The safety rules are ignored and kids are dying. It's not right. June 28th. Oh boy, I stirred up the hornet's nest. There's protesters and reporters and all kinds of people camping outside the steelworks now. They're blocking the trucks and such. They're real riled up. July 2nd. The soldiers came and cleared those folks out and posted guards with guns. Arthur was laughing about it today, talking about those commie weak whiners getting what's coming to them. I guess I gotta try something else to make things right. They're not commies. You're literally killing people because you're an arrogant fool. August 14th, 2077. Got fired today and booted off the premises. Said they know I was helping the protesters. Guess being kin doesn't matter. Arthur didn't even talk to me himself. I guess I have to find another way. Let's see whether Arthur's the kind of person who responds to, well, a child being kidnapped and blackmailed. Well, over to Grafton Dam. This is fun. Just wailing on them. And Grafton Dam sign. Caution, Grafton Dam is an automated facility. There are no personnel on the premises. If you wish to contact the Grafton Dam, please contact Mr. Quinton Gessie for assistance at our office is in Grafton.
Civilization. The Brotherhood and responders together have paid a high price to make that word mean something in Appalachia. Despite all the changes, farmers have worked the land. People have learned new skills, and we've built a new world. An the super mutants threaten all of that. I'm a soldier, a paladin, and I tell you that this is our moment. We will never be stronger, and the super mutants never weaker. If you're thinking in the heat of battle to run, to live to fight another day, know this. There is no other day. We win here, now. Responders and Brotherhood together, or we will die. So look to your left. Look to your right. Promise to give your all to protect them. And they will protect you. Make no mistake, this will be the toughest fight of our lives. But we will win. Because we're fighting for something. For each other. For our children. For civilization. Now, let's show these muties what we're made of.
Freddy's Adventure 3. Big secret. I worked. It worked. Uncle Otis got his foot. Got his foot in the trap. And slipped where I put the oil. He is so mad and yelling at me. He is stuck upside down now. Ha ha ha. I showed him. I'm going home. Freddy's Adventure 1. Freddy's Secrets. Uncle Otis got me a Grognak game. He's so cool. We got to get inside the dam. Uncle Otis said he was getting us food. I hope he gets pizza. Pizza is cool. I got some candles from a desk. Ha ha ha. Oh, candies. Free candies. I climbed and hid them. They are all mine. Bobby is gonna be jealous. Uncle Otis lets me do stuff. We are something in. Farted in the tubes here, and they stink, and the stinky ones get a prize. I won. I'm the best. Freddy the Great. This kid seems like a bit of a, well, he's clearly a moron, but he's also someone with a bit of a superiority complex, it would seem. Freddy's Adventure 2. More secret stuff. Uncle Otis got me my candies. Got my candies and took them. He says my teeth is gonna rot out. Not fair, Uncle Otis. Got gross food. He is all mad now and strolled by something fun. I want to go home and play with my rifle. Bam bam, I'm a good shooter. I get a rabbit, but now it is, I got a rabbit, but now it is dead and no fun. Uncle Otis sucks. I'm gonna get him. I want to go home, and he says no. I want candies, and he says no. I want to fart in the tubes, and he says no. I am gonna make traps like Pioneer Scouts said to do in the woods and catch Uncle Otis because I'm the greatest. Kid definitely have some issues. Arthur Wood's lighter. Funny though. Diary of Otis Pike. More of this diary. Still dumb to write it down. October 15th, 2077. Checked out the water park where the kid will be in a couple of days. Almost got caught too by dropping some Grafton Steel Mail protest leaflets to throw off people. October 17th, 2077. I knew the kid was a brat, but I had no idea. Maybe this wasn't a great plan. October 18th, 2077. We're holed up in the dam. I've got the place locked down tighter than a miser's cupboard. Not having much luck with a ransom. It's not like I wanted money. Just shut the plant down and get some safety people in there to make it better. October 20th, 2077. The kid was having fun with our great adventure. Now all he does is whine and draw rude pictures. I'm not sure who's the captive here. Arthur left a note at the ransom site. It said I could keep his kid. Wouldn't shut down the plant. Would let his only son go to save the country from commies. Nice. I swear that kid is plotting to kill me. He keeps bumping me when I'm on the catwalk. He was even playing with a bit of rope, saying he was practicing his Pioneer Scout knots, but I'm pretty sure he's making a noose. Shit. Yeah, how do you react when a kid is trying to kill you? I mean, that's pretty fucked up.
I got my own command now. Bet you never thought that would happen, right? With all the new blood sergeants training. I mean, night. Senior night. Met up with the representative of the responders. I told her our mission, to escort trade caravans, keep the freaks from the savage divide away from civilization, and maybe get the dam operational again. She was so grateful, it was almost embarrassing. Day one complete, but so far so good. But I miss you. And the hot shower. But mostly you. The old rules about fraternization, I don't know if they apply in the Brotherhood. Maybe we can just come clean and tell Paladin Taggarty about us. I know you'd like kids one day too, and we're not getting any younger. Promise you'll think about it. Love you.
That is a good point. I don't think the Brotherhood has any rules about fraternization, believe it or not. Because the Brotherhood don't recruit outsiders all that often. Well, like in the future games, they don't. Other than the player character. The player character can always join because they're the player character. So it's just a watch, basically. Why can't I make that, for fuck's sake? Very peculiar indeed. There's an officer somewhere. I have no idea where it is. I would have liked to have done the optional bit, but I can't. Thank you. That's the kid. Freddy's hasty note. Daddy, I can't find you and I'm scared. I hear lots of sirens and a man says I got to go with him to some secret place now, and he said Daddy gave money so I can go to the vault and be safe. Uncle Otis is at the dam. We had a fun time, except he was mean, so I left. Where are you? Damn. Woods Estate Terminal. Okay, property of Arthur Wood. Warning, unauthorized use is prohibited by law. Personal. Molly. I'm both frightened and excited that we will soon be parents. I'm so glad you've agreed to let Otis work with you at the mill. I know he irritates you, but he's my only brother and I love him. I've done a silly thing and ordered an expensive thing for the baby. I hope you don't mind. I love you. Your Molly. Camp Tomahawk. Dear Mr. Wood, thank you for giving us the chance to make your son, Freddy, a Pioneer Scout. We are thrilled that he will be attending camp with us this summer, as we have healthy activities planned to enrich his experience. Please don't hesitate to contact us if you have concerns or questions. Scoutmaster James A. Jameson. Nanny Annie. Mr. Wood, thank you for your recent inquiry about upgrades for your Miss Nanny model. I have dispatched a catalogue to you in the post with our newest inventions. Please let me know if I can assist you further. Respectfully, Jeff Perry, General Atomics International Sales Manager. Vault Tech Project Safe House. Mr. Wood, to answer your question, one, yes, there is room for both you and your son. Yes, the war efforts are greatly appreciated. Yes, you can arrange for your son to be delivered to a safe location in the event of the war, since you will likely be separated from him. If he is at either location you specified, his home, his school, we will be able to assist. No, his nanny will not be able to join him. Regards, Vault Tech. Company business. Safety data. Mr. Wood, I'm afraid the worker safety numbers this past quarter have increased drastically over the previous quarter. This might look pretty bad if released to the regulatory board, even with our government preferred status. Grafton Steel would take a lot of heat. Maybe we can adjust the format of the report. This is another argument for automated workers, though. Repair costs are a lot cheaper than lawsuits. What do you think? Stacy. Morale. Mr. Wood, worker morale has been plummeting. I started asking around and I think Otis Pike is bad-mouthing the company. With your permission, I will arrange for his activities to be watched more closely. Respectfully, Stacy. Termination. Mr. Wood, I've terminated the problem employee and reported his commie learnings to the authorities as you requested. Under the Wartime Workers Act, he could hang for treason. If you want to press this issue, please advise Stacy. Production. Mr. Wood, our numbers are dropping fast. I think the workers are intentionally damaging automated help. I'm not sure they're going to be the best solution in these turbulent times. Can you investigate whether corruption is a conscription is an option while we wait for the delivery of more automated workers? Regards, Stacy. Damn. Estate controls. Offline. Well, the kid got into a vault, I guess. Well, He was on the way to a vault, that doesn't mean he got in. That and that kid was a proper dick. Server seems to be having some issues today.
Freddy? This writing. This is Freddy's. His father did not want Freddy with the uncle, but so much love Freddy had for him. Oh, mon petit chou. So terrible for my brave boy. This you found at the home? Oh, my poor child. Such fear. The writing says he went to safety before the bombs. This means he could live! Thank you. These things I have found, you must take as a reward.
Thank you.
Nice. Well, not this shit again. Hello, this is a thing. weird little place up in the mountains. Birdwatcher's note. Always used to come here and watch the birds, listen to the wind in the chimes and the leaves. A quiet place where I could rest between developments. Don't know who built it, but it's always been my little silence slice of heaven. Then the world was set on fire. Haven't seen a bird in years, to be honest. Anyway, if you're like me, you might never want to leave this place, but don't forget that just because the world is gone and needs fixing doesn't mean we can all just hide from our problems out in the woods when you had a good rest. Get back out there and help somebody. And hey, maybe you'll spot a bird or two someday. Interesting place. It's rather pretty as well. Yep, I found it. You ready for the reveal? Bum 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 bum. It's a vault. Without a texture. Photo time. Now, as far as many of us can tell, this place isn't actually supposed to be here. I'll show you what I mean. There have been issues with the terrain being a bit floaty around here because it's not fully implemented. That and the fact that there's a giant purple splotch for a missing texture on the fracking door tells us that it's not done. Bit of an odd place to put a volleyball court. It was a close game. Also, this place didn't have an actual road going up to it. Which is kind of weird. Although, maybe Bethesda will add a proper road in when they release it. Well, I guess it's a track. Because there are power lines running along it. Yeah, sorry for the chug there. Yeah. Mr. Handy. Rochelle.
Chewy. I am always looking for more help from anyone with a recon scope and an interest in animal behavior. Too bad. If only you had a recon scope, you could assist me in a scientific endeavor.
How weird. Let's discover this farm. Then I'll finish up. So I need to go eat. I'm gonna find out what's causing those bloody pop-ups as well. And nuke it off of my computer. John and Aaron Holt's last words. Lowell has the damn key to the granary. I know he does, that bastard. He's playing dumb. Said he has no clue where it is. Dang rabid dog. Dogs attacked me. My leg got pretty tore up. There's some medicine stored in the granary storage. I'm not going to make it. I could have been living the life of Riley, but it's too late now. Time to make peace and join the rest of my family. Note to Laurie, if you find my body, screw you. Sean's journal. Sean Aaron Holt's journal. John and I are sick of hearing Lowell talk about Chicago all the damn time. Lowell wants us to pack up and head that way. Who gives a shit about Chicago? I always thought we should travel more south to see if any of our cousins survived. John and I can't find the key to the granary shed where we hoarded ammo and medicine. Radiation sickness has taken the best of me. Without meds, I'll probably die within days. Yep. Don't need two banjos. I'll be taking that, thank you very much. Right. Well. I'm going to finish up for the evening. Well, for now anyhow. I will see you in the next bit. Alright, tune in next time. Bye.